Welcome back again. So in the last lecture we have discussed about the various crystal planes and we talked about these two planes 100 and 111, and we have already seen different properties of these planes. Various properties we have seen. We have already discussed about these properties, but I would like to tell you this, that these are the not only the only properties. Okay, we have more properties of these planes. Okay, and I will come back to this particular discussion. What are the other properties of these planes? Okay, in the later section of the lectures. So up to this, we have discussed about the crystal planes, and some of the properties I have discussed till now. So now I would like to go to some other topic, okay? And I will be again coming back to this particular properties of these planes, okay? Which is very much important because some of the concept we need to discuss first, and then we need to discuss again what are the other properties of the 111 plane or 100 plane, because those properties are very important to understand. So now our next topic for the today's discussion is, as I told you about the Lucrezian crystal growth of single silicon crystal. Okay, so when we did this discussion, I told you that generally we do have a certain type of substrate which is having p-doped or n-doped substrates. Okay, p-doped or n-doped substrates we have. So how to get such substrate like p-doped or n-doped? So basically, as I explained earlier, that while growing the crystal, okay, while growing the crystal, I have taken another picture. Okay, I have taken this another picture from the book. This is given in the SMZ book. Okay, you can find this particular picture in the SMZ book. Okay, so while growing the crystal, what we can do is we can also add a certain dopant impurities. Okay, we can certain impurities we can add, okay, in the melt. So it will be dissolved or it will be mixed with the melt, and then we draw the crystal using the Zukrelski process. Okay, then that dopant will be incorporated into the crystal. So this way we can incorporate the dopant into this crystal. Fine. So basically, what we are doing is we are adding the dopant in the belt itself. Okay, so we can add them in a particular controlled way, in a particular amount to get a particular concentration of the dopant, and then we have to start drawing the crystal. So basically, in this particular discussion, we have to understand what will be the distribution of the dopant when we draw the crystal. Okay, so what I actually want to discuss in this particular lecture is, if we have added a certain dopant in the melt, okay, then melt will have a certain concentration of the dopant material, impurity materials, okay, whatever we want to add, p type or n type, then whatever be the concentration of the melt, do the same concentration we are going to grow in the crystal also. Okay, whether it will be a uniform distribution of the dopant concentration or we are going to get some other distribution. Okay, so that's why I have given the name like distribution of dopants in grown crystal. Okay, so how this dopant material is going to be distributed when we draw the crystal, that we have to look at. Fine. So now basically there are lots of p-type and n-type dopants, but you can see that basically very popular material for p-type dopant is boron, and the n-type dopant is phosphorus. Okay, in the case of silicon, right? So other materials are also there that can also be used for doping this particular crystals. Fine. So now let us say any suitable material, okay, any suitable dopant we have added. Let us say it is p-type or n-type, okay. So we have added to this melt, okay, before starting drawing this crystal. So once it is get mixed with the melt, then we have to start the drawing the crystals out of this melt. So now what we have done is we have defined certain terms. So let us try to understand it. Okay, so what is those terms? So one of the term that we have defined is, which is called as the equilibrium segregation coefficient. Okay, so you can see we are defining this term. Okay, we are defining this term equilibrium segregation coefficient. Okay, so at equilibrium condition, when this solidification starts. Okay, so at a particular time when it will be in the equilibrium condition, there is a particular pulling rate, and due to this pulling and due to the reduction in the temperature, there will be a solidification and there will be a formation of the crystal take place. Okay, so at any equilibrium state, okay, we can define a term which is called as the segregation coefficient. And how we have defined this term, just look at it. So we have defined as K naught equals to Cs upon Cl. So one thing that I would like to let you know that we have used triple parallel lines. Okay, there are three parallel lines you can see instead of just two parallel lines. So you remember that this particular symbol is signifies that it is by definition we have made this relation. Okay, we are defining it like K not equals to Cs upon Cl. We have not derived it from anywhere. It is not a derivation part. You have not derived it. Okay, so it is by definition we are defining a segregation coefficient by this particular relation. And what is this relation says? It is something Cs upon Cl. So now just look at that. What is this Cs? Okay, so Cs we have defined as the equilibrium concentration of the dopant. Okay, equilibrium concentration of the dopant in the solid. Okay, and then what Cl defines? Cl is defined as the equilibrium concentration of the dopant in the liquid near the interface. Okay, so basically what is this Cs and Cl is? So once we have added the dopant to the melt, okay, it will get mixed with the melt and we will get a certain doping concentration of the dopant, the melt. Okay, so we are particularly talking about near the surface. Okay, because we are actually drawing the melt, drawing the crystal near the surface. Okay, so we are talking about the concentration of the dopant near the surface. Okay, so what we are saying that we are drawing the crystal, so we will be having a certain dopant concentration in the solid and also we will be having a certain dopant concentration in the liquid or near the surface. Okay, so that's why we are saying it is the coefficient of Cs upon Cl. So concentration of the dopant in the solid or the crystal divided by concentration of the dopant in the liquid. Fine. So this way we have defined the segregation coefficient. Now I would like to tell you something about this segregation coefficient. Okay, you can actually it is some of the results that we have got from the experiments for the different dopants. Okay, so I would like to show you a certain segregation coefficient for different dopant materials. Okay, so I have taken this particular a particular table from the SMZ book, and the previous picture was also taken from the SMZ book. Okay, so this is some of the segregation coefficient for some of the dopant material you can see. Okay, so we are having a lots of dopant material. Okay, so the most popular, like we can say, we are having boron, we are having aluminium, gallium, okay, then indium. Okay, so this is gallium, indium. Okay, and the other materials we have. Okay, so we have so many dopants you can see. Fine, and then you can see one thing that this K naught, okay, the K naught that we have defined as the segregation coefficient, So this is the experimental results that I would like to show. Okay, this is experimentally found. Okay, they have found it experimentally, right? So what segregation coefficient they have found is, they have found it to be 8 into 10 to the power minus 1. Okay, so what it means, it is around 0.8. Okay, so this 0.8, it is again 10 to the power minus 3, 10 to the power minus 3, 10 to the power minus 4. Okay, and then here it is greater than 1. Okay, then again we are getting 10 to the power minus 2. Okay. Again, you can see 10 to the power minus 1, minus 2, minus 4, minus 2, minus 4, and minus 5. So what we can see in most of the cases, if you see most of the cases, if you neglect this, okay, then most of the cases, what we can understand is our segregation coefficient is less than 1. It is experimental result. Okay. So we found that the segregation coefficient is less than 1. So what it signifies, the segregation coefficient is less than 1. So it signifies that the dopant concentration in the solid, okay, is less than the dopant concentration in the liquid. Fine. So what we are saying is, because segregation coefficient K0 we have defined as CS upon CL, where CS is the concentration of the dopant in the solid. Okay. So CS upon CL is less than 1. Fine, it means that the concentration in the solid is less than concentration in the melt. So that this is what we mean to have this K0 less than 1. Okay. What we are saying, dopant concentration in the crystal is less than dopant concentration in the melt. Okay. This is what we have. So now just you try to look at what is the significance of having K0 less than 1. Okay. What is the significance? And we will also be studying what will be the significance if K0 is greater than 1. Okay. And if K0 is equals to 1. Okay. What is the result going to be? That we have to look at. Fine. So now we just try to see a different cases. Okay. So first case, when we have just taken the melt. Okay. We have not yet started any drawing the crystal. We have not started anything. Fine. So what we can do is, we have taken the our polysilicon material, okay, then we have raised the temperature, we got the melt, and within the melt what we have done is we have added the dopant, any dopant we have added. Fine. So now we have not started yet, we have not started drawing any crystal. So what we are assuming is, let us say that the initial weight of the melt is M0. Okay, this is what we are considering, the initial weight of the melt. Okay, so you remember that when we are talking about the initial weight of the melt, okay, the weight means this melt is constituted of both your polysilicon charge as well as the impurity dopants. Okay, so both we have added, and then whatever be the total weight of the melt, that we are calling it as M0. Fine. So you can understand that if M0 is the total weight of the melt, you can understand when we draw the crystal, okay, when we draw the crystal out of this melt, the crystal cannot have its weight greater than M0. It's quite obvious. Okay, it cannot have greater than M0. The maximum weight of the drawn crystal would be going to be M0. Okay, it will be going to be M0. So just do not consider about that the crucible is going to be dissolved, and a little bit increase in this particular weight may be observed, but ideally it cannot go greater than M0. Okay, so maximum weight of your crystal that is going to be drawn will be equals to M0. Okay, so now what we have understood is the initial weight of the melt is around M0. And the initial dopant concentration in the melt is C0. Okay, this is our initial value. Okay, we have added certain dopant. Okay, then we can say that the dopant concentration initially in the melt is C0. So you can, I think you must be able to understand what we mean to say the concentration. Let us say we have a 1 liter of milk. Okay, and within 1 liter of the milk is pure milk is, let us say half liter, and the half liter is water. So the total mixture is having its volume is equals to 1 liter. Okay, and out of that 1 liter, there is 50% of the water. So what we can say that is 50% concentration. Okay, 0.5 concentration is there of the water in that particular entire volume. Okay, so in a similar way, we can also calculate the initial dopant concentration. So C naught means the total weight of this particular melt along with the dopant, and then we can calculate the dopant concentration. The weight of the dopant divided by the total weight of the melt, and that way we can calculate the initial dopant concentration in the melt. Let us say it is C naught. Now just try to look at in the second case. In the second scenario, what we can have is, let us say we have started the drawing the crystal, and we have drawn the crystal of this much of length. Okay, we have drawn this particular crystal out of this melt. Okay, and in a particular time, let us say the drawn crystal that we have got, okay, so it is actually having its weight which is equals to m. Okay, so we have drawn a particular crystal, okay, at a particular time, and its weight that we got is about m. So now when we got this particular weight m, okay, then obviously there will be a reduction in the weight of the melt, and obviously that weight will become m naught minus m. Fine. So this will be becoming the total, means the total weight of the melt, okay, after drawing this particular crystal, that will be equals to m naught minus m. So now you can see, we can also calculate what is the amount of dopant which are available in the melt after drawing this crystal. Fine. So weight of the melt that will be left after drawing this particular crystal of having weight m, okay, so let us say the weight of the melt, obviously it will be m naught minus m, and we know that some of the dopant will also be incorporated into this particular crystal. Okay, so it will also be incorporated. So there should be a certain reduction in the weight of the dopant in the belt also. Fine. So when it will be, there is a reduction, then what we are saying is, what is the available amount of dopant in the melt, okay, after growing this particular crystal. So let us say that amount is S. Okay, it must be in the gram or kg, okay, whatever. So it must have the unit of mass, right? So let us say it is something S gram. Okay, amount of dopant is available in the melt after drawing this particular crystal. Fine. So now at the second, we can go for another case. Let us say after a certain amount of time, this keep on growing. Okay, this particular crystal will keep on growing. Crystal puller will keep pulling this crystals up. Okay, and then we will get additional length of this particular crystal. Okay, so just you go to this particular picture. Okay, so let us say that in the case 3, we have further drawn this crystal, and then we got this much of length. Okay, a little more weight is added to the crystal. Okay, so what we are saying is, so let us say that we have added DM weight, okay, very fractional weight of DM we have added to this particular crystal, okay, at some other instant of time, okay, because we need to keep on pulling this crystal until this melt will be finished. Okay, once the melt is over, then only we can stop pulling this particular crystal. Fine. So let us say we have added a little more weight, like fractional weight we are talking about, it is DM. Okay, so this much of weight we have added. Okay, let us say, so at the same time there will be a reduction in the weight of your total melt is also be there. Okay, so it will also reduce. Fine. So when it is reducing, we can see, we can talk about, there will be a reduction in the available amount of dopant in the melt. Okay, so obviously the total weight of the melt is reducing, so melt weight is also reducing, and as well as the weight of the dopant or the amount of dopant which was available at this case 2, it is also going to be reduced. Okay, so let us say that this amount S is actually reduced by a fractional amount, which is DS. Okay, so I am putting a negative sign that there is a reduction. Okay, there is a reduction in the amount of dopant in the melt available in the case 3. Fine. So if you understood up to this point, okay, if you understood up to this point, all this case 1, case 2, and case 3, okay. Now what we can do is we can calculate what will be the dopant concentration, okay, dopant concentration in the melt, okay, in case 2. We can calculate this. Fine. So obviously, how do we calculate the dopant concentration? We have to calculate the dopant concentration by amount of dopant divided by the total weight of the melt. Okay, so what we can say, dopant concentration in case 2, the liquid, okay, that we can calculate. So if we define it by the Cl, then the Cl will be equals to how much? It will be S divided by M0 minus M. Because the total weight of the melt which is left in the case 2 is M0 minus N. The amount of dopant which is left in the melt is S. Okay, and therefore the concentration will be S divided by M0 minus N. So what we are saying is, in the case 2, we are saying that the doping concentration of liquid is how much? We are defining it by a term Cl. Okay, so Cl will be equals to S divided by M0 minus M. Okay, so this is our doping concentration in the liquid in the case 2. Now what we can have is, we can have in the case 3, okay, what we are saying that for incremental amount of weight dm, okay, incremental amount of weight dm of the crystal, okay, the corresponding reduction in the dopant from the melt is, so what we want to calculate, what will be the fractional reduction in the dopant amount, okay, what will be the fractional amount which is going to be reduced in the dopant when we are incrementing the weight of your crystal or your solid by dm, okay. So that will be equals to minus ds we have written, okay. So that can be given by this equation, okay. This is minus ds equals to cs into dm, okay, cs into dm. So what is this cs? We have already defined this term cs. So cs is the concentration of dopant concentration in the solid, okay, dopant concentration in the solid. So whatever be the dopant concentration in the solid, if we multiply it by the dm, a fractional change in the weight, fractional increment, okay, fractional increase in the weight, then we are going to get the fractional reduction of the amount of dopant in the liquid. Okay, it will be same as the fractional reduction in the liquid of the dopant. Okay, because what CS reflects here, it is the dopant concentration in the solid. Fine. So dopant concentration in the solid will be multiplied with the dm, and then it will be giving you the reduction in the dopant amount, okay, fractional reduction in the dopant in the melt. Okay, so this is in the case 3 that we have got. Now we have already defined certain terms, okay, we have already defined our segregation coefficient, and that was defined as k naught equals to cs upon cl. Okay, so what was that? It is solid concentration, dopant concentration in the solid divided by the dopant concentration in the liquid. So from this expression, what we can get is, we can get cs equals to ks into cl. Okay, we are just multiplying this. So cs equals to ks into cl, and then we can substitute for the cl. So cl will be equals to s upon m0 minus n, and we can get cs equals to ks into s upon m0 minus n. Okay, so this is our equation for our solid or concentration of dopant in the solid. Okay, now further what we can have is, if we can combine this equation number 3 and 4, we are just combining these two equation. Okay, after combining this two equation, we can write this equation in this form. Okay, so if you just substitute for this CS, which is equals to KS S in, divided by M naught minus M into dm. Okay, then what we can have is we can take this S term to the denominator of the ds, and I'm just transferring this negative sign to the right hand side. Fine. So this value will be becoming ds upon S equals to minus k naught then dm upon m naught minus m. So this will be the equation that we are going to get after combining the equation number 3 and 4. So now what we can see, this actually shows you the fractional change. Okay, fractional change in the dopant amount. Okay, fractional change in the dopant amount. Okay, so how your dopant is going to be changed, fractional change in the dopant. Okay, similarly this is also showing you the fractional change in the weight of your solid. Okay, how our solid is going to be changed, how it is going to be solidifying. Okay, fractional changes. Okay, now what we can do is we can go for the integration of this particular equation in both hand sides. Okay, so what we can do is we can go for the integration, and we can keep the integration limit as its initial value to its final value. Okay, so we have to look at for the initial value to its final value. Okay, so this dn denotes you what it denotes, it denotes the fractional change in the amount of or the weight of your crystal which is going to be solidified. Okay, so we are drawing the crystal, so slowly it is gaining the weight. Okay, so what is the fractional change in the weight, and similarly what it tells you that what is the fractional change in the dopant amount when we are keep drawing the crystal. So basically what we have said is, we said, so let us say what was the initial conditions. Okay, what was the initial condition, what was the final condition of the dopant. Okay, so that we have to look at, and what will be the initial condition for your solid, and what will be the final condition of the solid. So we have to go for the initial and the final conditions. Okay, so basically if you see the initial conditions, okay, so for the initial conditions what we can got is, so what we have defined is what is the total initial amount of dopant that we have added. Okay, what was the initial condition that we have added in the case 2, you can see. So in the case 2, what we are saying that initial value of the total dopant was, we have taken the total weight of the melt was m naught. Okay, and initial concentration of the dopant was c naught. So total amount of dopant initially in the case 1, that was your c naught into m naught. If you multiply it, you will be getting the total amount of dopant that we have added initially by weight. Okay, so this will be giving you c naught into m naught. Fine, so it will be giving you c naught into m naught, because we have defined it as m naught is the initial mass of your total melt, and this is the concentration of your dopant. So if you multiply them together, then you will be getting the initial total amount of your dopant that you have added in the melt. Okay, when the crystal was not drawn, okay, it was not started. And then in the second case, the amount of dopant that was left in the melt after drawing the weight up to m, so it was s. Okay, so what we are saying that it is going from c naught m naught to s. Fine, so it is initial value, it was the final value in the case 2. Similarly, in the case 1, what we can see is, in the case 1, what we have done is, we have not drawn any particular crystal in the case 1. So the mass, initial mass was 0. Okay, and then in the case 2, we have drawn the crystal whose weight was up to m. Okay, so we have gone from 0 to m. So our m is a variable, you just remember that. Okay, m is a variable. This mass will keep on increasing this mass will keep on increasing. So it will start from zero and it will go up to m naught, because m naught is the total weight of your melt. Okay, so it will go up to m naught. Similarly, you can think of it is started from c naught m naught, and then this s is also a variable, and this s will go to zero when this entire crystal cooling is over. Okay, so this will be going to be zero. So now we can go for the integration of this. Okay, then what we have to do is we have to do a little modification. We can make a substitution for this. Okay, so if you go for the substitution, what we can substitute is we can substitute m naught minus m equals to x. So a little bit mathematics you can do, you will get minus dm equals to dx, and then we can substitute this when m tends to zero. Okay, m tends to zero, then x tends to m naught. Similarly, you can calculate when m tends to m, then x tends to m naught minus m. The very simple mathematics we can do. So basically, what equation we are going to get? We will be getting this expression. Okay, so c naught m naught, again the left hand side we have not disturbed anything, but in the right hand side this is going to be dx upon x, and then this is m naught to m naught minus m. Okay, so then if you do this integration, a very simple integration you can do, so we will get the log. So this expression we are going to get, we are going to get log s, and its limit is from c naught to m naught, c naught m naught to s, and then here it is m naught to m naught minus m. So further we can simplify, so it will be coming as log s minus log c naught m naught, and then equals to k naught, and then log 1 minus m upon m naught. Fine. So what I have done is I have reduced one of the steps here. Okay, you can write like log m naught minus m, then again log m naught, and then there you can divide the m naught, because it is log m minus n formula you can use. Okay, so here you are getting log m minus log n, so that can be written as log m divided by n. So you will get this expression. Okay, log 1 minus m upon m naught. Now what we have to do is we can replace this s. Okay, we can replace this s by using the expression number 2. Okay, so in this expression number 2 you can see we can write this s equals to cl multiplied with the m naught minus m. Okay, so cl into m naught minus m, so this expression we can got. Now we have further defined this expression, okay, in which you can get the cl equals to cs upon k naught. Okay, so ultimately what you are going to get s equals to, you will be getting cs upon k naught, k naught cs multiplied with the m naught minus m divided by k naught. Okay, so that we can replace. So after replacing it, what we are getting is we are getting log cs m naught minus m divided by k naught. Then the rest of the terms I have not disturbed, it is as it is. Fine. So now what we can do is I can convert this particular term in this form. Okay, it is log 1 minus m upon m naught. So what I will be doing is I will be taking m naught common. Okay, so if you take m naught common, you will be getting 1 minus m upon m naught. Okay, and then here you will get cs m naught divided by k naught. So what I can do is I can write like log m into n formula, so log m plus log n. Okay, so that way I can write. So you will be getting this expression. Okay, so the our expression will be log cs m naught divided by k naught plus log 1 minus m upon m naught, then again this term and this term. I have not disturbed. Okay, so further we can do the simplification. I can transfer this term to this side. Okay, then this is again log m minus log n, and then again I can divide it. Okay, so after doing this simplification, you will be getting this expression, log cs upon c naught k naught, and equals to this particular expression you will get. Okay, the further simplification will give you this particular result. Okay, I think getting this expression from this expression is not very tough, a very simple step you can do. Okay, so this will go to the power of this, because log n to the power n can be written as n log n. Okay, so that formula you can use, it will go to the power of this. Okay, and then what we can do, we can remove the log from both the sides, and then you will get the cs equals to c naught k naught 1 minus m upon m naught k naught minus 1 the power. Okay, so this is very important result. Okay, so let us try to explore a little bit about this expression, what it says. Okay, so basically if you can see in this expression, we have got the expression for our concentration of dopant in the solid. This CS is for concentration of the dopant in the solid. Okay, the solid means the crystal that we are drawing. So this is the expression for that. And here the C naught is the initial concentration of the dopant in the melt. Okay, it was initial concentration. And K naught is your segregation coefficient. Fine. So it is your segregation coefficient, and it is a constant for a different dopant material. Okay, it is a material specific parameter. Okay, so it is not in your hand. Okay, so different material will have a different value for K naught. And then we are having 1 minus M upon M naught. So this M upon M naught is giving you a fractional solidification. Okay, because M is the variable, M naught is the initial weight of the melt. Okay, so this M was initially 0, and then it can go up to capital, it will go up to M naught. The maximum value of capital M could be M naught, because this M is representing the amount of it is the weight of your crystal that we are growing. So initially the weight must be 0, okay, when the crystal pulling was not started. And when this crystal pulling is over, the maximum weight that it can have is M equals to M naught. So that's why we are saying it is a fractional solidification of your crystal. Okay, so this is one of the parameter, very important parameter. So now try to look at this particular equation, and let us say, assume that as I have already shown you that this K naught is having a different values, okay, different values, and basically this K naught is less than unity most of the dopant materials. It is experimentally found, experimental result. Fine. So now let us say, just for the simplification, let us say if K naught is equals to unity, let us say, okay. So when K naught equals to unity, then what we can see is this K naught will become 1. So 1 minus 1 will become giving you 0. Okay. So it will become 0. So something is having the power of 0 means it will become 1. So it means that this entire term will become 1, and this K naught is we have taken as unity. So CS will be equals to C naught. Okay, CS will become equals to C naught. So what does it mean? It means that whenever we are choosing the segregation constant, okay, segregation coefficient equals to 1, in that case, the concentration of the dopant, okay, concentration of the dopant in the solid is same as the initial concentration of the dopant in the melt. Okay, so, and it will not depend on while we are growing the crystal, okay, because this M will keep on changing. So whatever be the weight of the crystal, it will not depend on the weight of the crystal. So when we are growing the crystal, it will keep a constant value, and that constant value is equals to C naught. Okay, so there is no variation in the concentration of the dopant in the solid and the initial concentration of the dopant in the liquid. Both are same. Both are same. It is not changing, and it is not depending on the value of the weight of your crystal that has been grown. Okay. So I have taken this particular analysis from your SMC book. Okay, so this analysis is also given there. Okay, so you can, first of all, you can see this particular picture, what we are trying to show here. Okay, so you see here we have on the x-axis fractional solidification or fraction solidified. Okay, so this fraction solidified reflects to this particular ratio M upon M naught. This ratio is being taken there. Fine. We are talking about capital M upon M naught. Fine. Then on this axis, they have plotted CS divided by C naught. Okay. So this CS divided by C naught we have plotted. Fine. So just now we have taken one of the case when K naught equals to unity. Fine. you can see there are a family of curves that have been plotted. Okay, these are the different plots that we can see, and this plot is for different values of k naught. Okay, so k naught is 0.01, k naught is 0.05, then k naught is 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, and so on. And this is the curve. You can see this is the curve k naught corresponding to equals to 1. Okay, so what we can see is when this k naught is equals to unity, you can see this cs divided by c naught is unity. Okay, so it means that either you can say that cs divided by c naught, or you can say that cs equals to c naught. Okay, so basically what we can say, this line is uniform. Okay, it is right from 0 to, so m upon m naught is equals to 0. What it means, the initially there were no crystal, so capital M was 0. So this fraction will become 0. Okay, so this curve is started from 0. And the maximum value of M is equals to capital M naught, so this fraction will become 1. Okay, so you can see this values, it is varying from 0 to 1. So initially it was 0. And when it is drawing the crystal, when we are keep on increasing the weight of the crystal, okay, we are increasing the weight of the crystal, okay, this concentration is uniform. Okay, so what it means, the crystal is having the same dopant concentration as our melt was having initially, and it is constant throughout the drawing of the crystal, and it doesn't depend on the weight of the crystal. Okay, it doesn't depend on the weight of the crystal, it is uniform. Okay, similarly you can see, I can take another picture, another value of the k naught. So let us say if we talk about something k naught equals to 0.1, let us say about, you just talk about this particular picture, this particular curve. Okay, so when we take k naught equals to 0.1, you can see that this value k naught is 0.1 minus 1, so it will become minus 0.9. okay, so when it becomes minus 0.9, okay, you can find that these particular value, okay, these particular value, okay, this particular value will start increasing when m upon m naught will increase. Okay, so when m upon m naught will increase, this particular entire term will start increasing because this power is negative. You can work out that, it is very simple to do the calculation. Okay, so what we are having is, when m equals to m naught, when m equals to 0, it will be 1. So 1 to the power, whatever 1 to the power will be remains 1. Okay, so there is no problem that we can have. So 1. And then we are having k naught, which is equals to, we are taking as 0.1, then whatever is the c naught value. So it is started with the 0.1 because we are plotting cs upon c naught. So it is started with the 0.1, 10 to the power minus 1. And then what you can see is, as this weight of the solidified or the crystal is increasing, okay, when we are starting, we have started the crystal growth. So as soon as the growth of the crystal starts and it is gaining the weight, this concentration, okay, the concentration of the dopant in the crystal is increasing. Okay, it is increasing, it is increasing. Okay, and it is not uniform like the case when k naught was equals to 1. This is one of the important observation, and the same observation you can make for any value which is of k naught which is less than 1. You can see for all the curves, you can see, okay, there is a particular rate of increment. So you can see in the 0.9, okay, this curve is almost flat. And after a certain value of m upon m naught, again it is started increasing, and the slow increment you can observe, and it is in keep on increasing, okay, and it is going up to this point. Fine. So it means that what this particular picture tells you, okay, just you assume another thing, like when k naught is greater than 1, which is not a practical case, but just for the sake of completeness, okay, of this theoretical study, what we can have is, we can have the k naught which is greater than 1. So let us say if it is greater than 1 and it is 2, let us say we are taking k naught equals to 2. In that case, it will be 2 minus 1, and this power will become positive. Okay, So you can observe that when power will become of positive, then when you calculate this factor, okay, 1 minus m upon m naught, this will be decreasing with the increase of the fractional solidified. Okay, so it will be increasing. It will be decreasing when we increase the m upon m naught, and therefore we are getting this type of curve. See, and what it means that, so the initial concentration of the solid initial concentration of the dopant was this much, and then this concentration will keep on decreasing. Just keep on decreasing, okay. And it will keep on decreasing like that. Fine. So it will be following this particular curves. It will be keep on decreasing. So basically, what we want to tell, that if we are having a particular crystal, okay, we are having a particular single silicon crystal that we have drawn using the CZ process, okay, Jokralski process. Then you can assume that when k naught is less than one, okay, when k naught is less than one, as you can see, this Cs upon C naught is increasing. Okay, so it means that the dopant concentration at this point, okay, dopant concentration at this point will be the minimum, and when you keep on drawing, okay, the dopant concentration will be keep on increasing. Okay, it will keep on increasing as you go to the bottom. Okay, so at the bottom side, you will find that the concentration of the dopant is highest. Okay, dopant concentration will be highest in the solid. Okay, because k naught is less than one. So k naught is less than one. So its dopant concentration from top to bottom, when we are going in this direction, okay, this particular concentration of the dopant increase in the solid. Okay, similarly, if we had this k naught equals to one, okay, and this is the more idealistic thing if we could have, okay, if k naught is equals to one, you can see it is having a uniform picture, uniform line, okay, it is not changing at all, okay. And what does it mean? That if we have a segregation coefficient of any material which is equals to one, in that time when we draw the crystal, the entire crystal will have the same doping concentration of your impurity. It does not vary as we go from this top to bottom. It will not vary. Fine. So I hope this discussion must be clear, and you must be aware now that the concentration of the dopant in this particular ingot that we have got is not uniform if k naught is not equals to one. Okay, it cannot be uniform. Okay, and accordingly you have to know at what point, if you are cutting the wafer, what will be the dopant concentration, that you must be aware of. Okay, and accordingly you have to add the amount of dopant to your melt to get a particular profile. Fine, to get a particular profile. So I hope this discussion must be clear. So I will be talking more on this. So we can stop here for today. We will be meeting again in the next lecture. Okay. Thank you.